بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. First, we start with praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, the most merciful. Wallahi, because if it wasn't for His grace and His mercy, none of us would be here. None of us would be here. Because why am I any better than the one that is out in the park smoking pot? Why am I any better than the one that is in the club drinking up? Why am I any better than the one that is sleeping around? Why am I any better than the one that does not pray? It's the mercy of Allah that has allowed me to be here. It's the mercy of Allah that has allowed me to pray. It's the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that allowed me to be in such a gathering. So we thank Him and we praise Him. And we could never thank Him and praise Him enough. And that's why I remind every single one of us. And that's why whenever we talk, whenever we say anything, we should always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost. Because if it wasn't for Allah, we'll be doomed. If it wasn't for Allah, we'll be misguided. If it wasn't for Allah, we'll be on the track of hellfire. We'll be on the track of hellfire. And He tells us, كنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها. That you were on the edges of hellfire and He saved you from it. So don't ever think that alhamdulillah, now I'm praying, I could look down at the person that's not praying. Did you forget where you were a couple of years ago or a couple of months ago? Don't ever think that it's through my smartness and through my strength or through my, because it's got nothing to do with you. It's through His mercy. It's through His grace that He allows you to put your forehead down to Him. And this is when we have to come to understand. This is when we understand this. This is when we start singing. When I understand that I am misguided without the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm naked without the permission of Allah giving me clothes to wear. And I am hungry without, unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives me the permission for me to eat. That I'm nothing. This is what Allah wants us to understand. That without Him, you can't do anything. You can't go anywhere. This is what Allah wants you to understand. And that you're in His land. And you got to obey by His laws. You got no choice. You got no choice. This is His law, His land. And this is His laws. I've got no choice the way I want to live life. I must live life the way Allah wants me to live life. I must live life as a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I stand in front of Allah and I say to Allah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. When I say to Allah, Ya Allah, I worship You. In what state? In what sense? إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. In what? It said the word Abad derives from the word na'bud. What's a abad? We all know what a abad is. We all know what a abad. A abad is a slave. Something that you own. Something that you tell when to eat, how to eat, where to go, how to come. Because you own this person. So I worship Allah as if He owns me. And I do everything that He wants, the way He wants it. This is no choice. Because this is what we're created for. That's what we're created for. We're created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who's going to be the man that takes on this mission? Who's going to be the man that goes against all odds of the dunya that everybody doesn't like? Nobody likes you to grow a beard. Nobody likes you to go pray in the mosque. No, sit at home. Watch this movie with me. Do that with me. Stop being an outcast. Nobody likes that. But that's the direction of the Prophet ﷺ. He said that the deen started strange and the restart strange. So glad tidings to the strangers. So if you feel like you live in society And everyone's happy with you. Know that you're not a stranger. And know that you're not on the path of the Prophet ﷺ. Because until people start going against you, and people start hating you for you worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you want to follow the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, and you want to live the life of the Prophet ﷺ, that's when you know that you're on the right path. That's when you know that you're on the right path. But it takes a man to take on this mission. And every single one of us has got this manhood within him. But we just have to let it, we have to let it come out. We have to take these covers of dunya from us. Take these covers that have buried us. Wallahi, we've been buried with the dunya, with the deception. And know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. Wallahi, He loves every single one of us. But sad to say, wallahi, only a few are gonna come. Only a few will end up shining through. Only a few will end up shining through. Out of how many people came to the camp, how many people remain? How many people remain to tomorrow morning? How many people will end up doing the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ and going praying two rak'ah before they go home? How many people? How many people? I'll assure you, there's only a handful of people that want to follow the Prophet ﷺ. We claim we love the Prophet ﷺ, but it's not what you claim, it's what you do. It's how you live. It's not what you say. And this is what we want to implement to our life. I want to live my life like his life. My life is the life of the Prophet ﷺ. My way is his way. And no cutting corners, no nothing. I want to live my life like he lived life. Because he was the best man to walk the face of the earth. And I want to be with the best man on the day of judgment. This is my direction. To be in Jannah, Al-Firdaus, with the Prophet ﷺ. So it's not about you having the tools, it's about you knowing how to use them. It's not about you having a car, it's about you knowing how to get to where you need to get to. Because anybody could jump in their car but start heading towards Queensland instead of heading towards Sydney. We want to head towards Jannah Al-Firdaus. And for us to do that, we must understand where we're heading and how am I going to get there and what is the map that I have to follow. And it's all cleared up for us. But we just have to man up and take this responsibility. We have to take on this responsibility and never to turn back. Because the second you turn back is the second that you're going to be dragged back. So I'm going to Allah along the path of the Prophet ﷺ, full steam ahead, and nothing's gonna stop me. And whoever wants to join, it's open for everyone. The doors of paradise is open for anybody that wants it. But it's about you striving towards it. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those people that strive to the Firdaus. To make us from the people that follow the footsteps of the Prophet ﷺ. To make us from the people that learn about the way of the Prophet ﷺ. To live his life. And to be resurrected with him on the day of judgment. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen.